ونستعين به ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله واصحابه ومن تبعهم باحسان يوم الدين. يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون. يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والارحام ان الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم اعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. اما بعد فانه افضل الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وان شر الامور محدثاتها وان كل محدثه بدعه وكل بدعه ضلاله وكل ضلاله في النار. 900 years ago Imam al-Ghazali had written in his book this paragraph that I'm going to share with you today. He said, people will not be spared from the horrors of the Day of Judgment unless they think and ponder about it carefully in this life. Because Allah Almighty does not gather two fears in any of his worshippers. And he continued to say, and whosoever fears the horrors of the Day of Judgment in this dunya, he is spared from it in the hereafter. And he continued to say, I don't mean the fear that you shed tears and your heart trembles as you hear any words about the hereafter, and later on that day you would forget everything and you go back chasing your desires and disobeying Allah. This is not the fear at all. Whoever fears something runs away from it. And whoever wants something, he goes out to seek it. Nothing would save you except the fear that would prevent you from disobeying Allah Almighty. The fear that forces you to obey Allah Almighty. The foolish person, or the foolish fear, he continued to say, is to those who hear about the horrors of the hereafter, and all what they do is to say, oh Allah, spare us from the torture and the horrors and the fear of the hereafter. Yet they insist on disobeying Allah and following the desires that are wrongful in Islam. And that is the cause of their destruction. The devil laughs at these people. It is just an example. This is the Imam al-Ghazali I'm relating to. He continued to say, this is the same way as when you laugh about the story of a person who was chased by a beast in the desert. And behind that person is the fortress or the fort where he can hide in it and protect himself. And as the beast is moving towards that person to attack him, and he could see the fangs of the beast approaching him, he says, that person, I seek the protection of the fort and the long big walls behind it, and I seek the protections of the strong walls of that fort. He says it in his tongue while he is still in his place, rather than going inside that building and closing the gate to protect himself. How could that person protect himself from that beast? End of the paragraph. 900 years ago, has said it in Imam al-Ghazali, and you could feel it in yourself. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Muddathir, وَإِنَّهَا لَإِحْدَى الْكُبَرِ نَذِيرٌ لِلْبَشَرِ لِمَنْ شَاءَ مِنْكُمْ أَنْ يَتَقَدَّمَ أَوْ يَتَأْخَرَ. In Surah Al-Muddathir, verse 35 to 37, indeed the fire is the one of the greatest afflictions as a warning to humanity. To who? And watch what I'm saying. Listen carefully to these two, three words I'm going to say. To whoever wills among you to proceed or stay behind. Proceed or stay behind. Proceed or stay behind. It did not mention that there is somebody who is just there standing up. It's either you proceed, otherwise you are staying behind. It did not state that on your path towards the hereafter, there is something else than a road to heaven or road to hellfire. There's nothing in the middle. So either you proceed towards heaven or you stay behind. It is just an example of someone who pedals on a bicycle. As long as you are pedaling on the bicycle, you are moving forward. The minute you stop, you fall from the bicycle. Al-Imam Ibn al-Jawzi, 1,000 years ago, he said it in a statement. He said, this life is like a trap, and people are like birds. And the bird is seeking the bait that is in the trap, which are the seeds that the hunter has put in. And yet that bird forgot that once he goes to seek that seed, the trap will catch him, and that would lead to his death. And he said to continue, I see a lot of people nowadays, they behave in the same manner. All what they do is they only chase their desires, and they waste their time in desires and useless activities, and they do not consult their mind in the reality of the matter, of the life that they live in. They have exchanged with this short-term desire a long-term pleasure in the hereafter. And they have replaced in these short-term desires heaven that is waiting for them. And when someone comes to die, he started wishing, oh Allah, spare me a few moments so I can correct my behavior. And this said to him, Al-an wa qad asayt. Now you are saying it after disobeying Allah all that term. Take this example. Someone comes to you and gives you an offer. He says, I will give you the opportunity to spend the night in the most lavish, very nice, beautiful place on earth. And I will serve you the best food possible. And I will give you a companion that is the most beautiful companion, on one condition only, that next day I will put you in an oven and I will burn you. Would you take that deal or would you refuse it? أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان يوم الدين. Have you one day picked up the Quran, and as you started reading in it, did you sense that Allah Almighty is talking to you as you are reading the Quran? Every day that you read the Quran, and every day that you miss reading the Quran, is a day that Allah has withdrawn the blessings from it. Because the blessing is in the time, and in the time of we read the Quran, and reading the Quran that day would rest that day. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Sad, verse 29, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَتَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. A blessed book which we have revealed to you, that they might reflect upon it. Notice the word reflect upon it. You don't just read it, you reflect upon it. Reflection means that when you read the Quran, you read it and you understand what you are reading. You read it and you understand what the verse means. You read it and you figure out what is the message of Allah talking to you as you are reading the Quran. Reflection is the point that turns around a person, a lost person, to a person who can see the reality and the light of Allah. A blessed book which we have revealed to you, that they might reflect upon it, its verses, and those of understanding would be reminded. Reflection, and Allah would remind you. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one day he said to his companions, I wish I can see my brothers. They said to him, aren't we your brothers, Ya Rasulullah? He said, no, you are my companions. Our brothers are the ones we have not yet met, the generations that are coming. And in another hadith, he said to them, you are my companions, but my brothers are the ones who believed in me, and yet they did not see me. Therefore, aren't you excited to meet the Prophet of Allah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The Imam Ibn Taymiyyah said 800 years ago in a statement, he said, don't think that your responsibility is just performing wudu and praying. Your responsibility is that you carry this religion and you carry it and propagate it to the world around you. How much does Islam take from your life? How much is the sense of propagation of Islam you have it in yourself? How much are you willing to share Islam in the world around you? One thing I tell you, some people among us last year are not here this year because they died. Maybe you know them. Could be a family friend or a relative or a distant cousin. If you knew how the people in their graves are desperate just for one rak'ah, the sense of despair they have after they had seen the reality in their grave, you wouldn't waste a moment of your life. I ask Allah Almighty, what I have said is for us and not against us. And I ask Allah Almighty to give us the sight and the revelation to understand Islam fully. I ask Allah Almighty in this day to bless Muslims worldwide and unite Muslims everywhere. Allahumma fi al-mu'minina wal-mu'minat, al-muslimina wal-muslimat, al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat, innaka sami'un.